So my favorite fish in the house right now is the redtail catfish. He's downstairs in my 400 gallon heated pond. And tonight we're gonna feed him. I absolutely love him, he's a beast. Well, actually, I don't know if it's a him or her, but we're gonna feed him some raw shrimp. So let's get into it.
So here's the pond, guys. It's 400 gallons and I built it out of plywood and 2x4s. And there's the redtail catfish. My favorite fish in the house right now. Look at him, he's absolutely magnificent. I think the coloration on these things is just really what does it for me, and just the wide body, the personality, and just this, like, the speckled coloration on the, like, the top of the fish. It's just absolutely amazing. As you guys can tell, I'm obsessed. Let's grab some food here. This is raw shrimp. You can just get it at your basic grocery store. And I feed my fish a lot of this stuff just because shrimp is super high in protein and the fish absolutely adore it. One thing that I've learned about keeping these predator fish in this pond is that some of the fish can catch their food a lot easier than others. For instance, the redtail catfish probably has a lot more poor vision than the other cichlids and such, but it can probably smell the food 10 times better than the cichlids can. So what I try to do here is just make sure that everybody eats, because some of the fish, you know, like that iridescent, or the albino iridescent shark, doesn't, it rarely gets any food. And there's actually a spotted gar in this pond as well, but you never see him because he's always hiding. And it's just, it's hard to make sure that all these fish get adequate amounts of food, is what I'm saying. If it were up to these Midas cichlids, they would eat all the food that I threw in here. These things are absolutely hogs, and they actually kind of piss me off because they don't allow the other fish to get food, and they're just so, like, they're such ferocious eaters. Look at this. Like, they'll literally take it out of my hand. Like, it's absurd. And I'm trying to get this redtail enough food in his belly because he's my favorite fish right now, and I want to make sure that he's eating. Same with the gar. I love the spotted gar. They're just such kind of timid feeders that, you know, the worst part about keeping the predators is some of them have different feeding instincts. You know, redtail catfish, they're probably going to do a lot of their feeding at night, like most catfish, and that's where I just need to make sure all these fish are eating adequately. The gar, I couldn't even find him tonight, so I guess it is what it is. Look at the little blood pair, just kind of nitpicking in there. These Midas cichlids, they'd eat all the food in the pond if I let them. So what I kind of do here is just kind of like just let all the food, just dump it all in there and just have hopes that the redtail catfish is getting enough food and he's feeding on adequate amounts of the shrimp. So, but yeah, he's absolutely beautiful. My favorite fish in the house right now. If you're thinking about getting a redtail catfish, you need to definitely do your research. They're awesome fish, but I would not keep them in an aquarium. So, and the redtail actually likes to hide most of the time. So what I do is I built this little, I didn't build it, but I found this plastic cage and I kind of cut a hole in the side of it. That way the fish can kind of like go in there and hide, because, you know, a lot of catfish like to hide during the day and then come out at night. And that's what redtails usually do. So this is kind of like his little hut. He absolutely loves it. He lives in there nonstop. I took it out for the feeding video in itself. I always try to set a goal with myself that I'll hand feed the redtail catfish from my hand. But I'm kind of a scaredy cat because these things, like, their mouths can consume crazy large huge things. It could probably swallow my hand, if we're being honest. At this size, I bet he's maybe like 15 inches. I bet he could like swallow my hand. I just saw a Facebook group post the other day of one of these redtail catfish swallowing an entire algae cleaning magnet. The thing was like 2 inches by 4 inches long, and you could see it in its poor stomach. Like, I felt so bad, but it just goes to show you that these things, they will literally eat close to anything that they like. I've heard so many stories of people just like dropping like clips, or just like the heater clips, they fall to the bottom, the catfish eat them, they die. Just, they kind of almost eat things out of pure boredom. Just, you know, they're so used to just kind of like inhaling everything that could possibly be food. And it kind of sucks because sometimes might be, that stuff is plastic kind of or like gravel, and it's just it doesn't get passed. So
like live
guys, I want to inform you that we did a live stream on my normal or my regular channel, Palmer Aquatics, completely deep diving into talking about redtail catfish with my buddy Dusty. He's a redtail catfish guru, yeah, and he's kind of the one that got me into him. Look at this pond. He has this is kind of like what grew my passion for redtail catfish. So we did a deep dive in talking about pretty much everything having to do with redtail catfish and these awesome fish. If you're thinking about keeping them and you want to like do a little bit of research, or maybe you just feel like hanging out, it was a super cool live stream. A lot of people came out in the live chat, and if you want to check make sure to subscribe to my regular channel, Palmer Aquatics, and hit that notification bell, because when we go live, that's when you know we go live. So that's pretty much the only way you're going to figure it out. Or you can watch the playback. That is also an option. So without further ado, guys, hopefully you enjoyed me feeding the redtail catfish tonight. Redtail catfish feedings are always awesome because they are such beautiful fish, and they're voracious feeders. And it's my favorite fish in the house. I've said that five times now. If you're thinking about getting one, just make sure you have the adequate setup and go about and do so, because these fish are awesome. And just kind of try to have a long-term plan for keeping these fish. I'm preaching like I'm a grandpa or something.